Hello, so I'm back in Grindelwald today. First of all, just to show off the view at the moment. Very nice. What I'm doing today is I'm hiking from Grindelwald to Lauterbrunnen. There we go, that sign says Lauterbrunnen, 23 kilometers. Essentially going from one valley to another one over the peaks in between them. There, another great day. Take that picture from that frame. I'll put it in my pocket so that every day you're with me. I keep you close to my heart. Give me one more kiss before the boys arrive. Look at how clear this water is. So this one here is called Rostock, which stands at 2,600 meters, and this is Eiger, which is quite a well-known mountain in this region, which is at just under 4,000, pretty much 4,000, and people, not many people, but people have climbed up this face to the top. So the other day when it was like the really sunny day, I was like, I ended up like taking the scooter down and stuff. That is from this kind of mountains over here. I'll be honest, I'm not quite sure if whereabouts like the peak I got to was and stuff. I think it might just be like a bit beyond what you can actually see. But yeah, so Grindelwald is in the middle between me and the other side right now. So like I say, I've done like the far end of Grindelwald that side. And I've done the far end of Lauterbrunnen, which is like well over that way now. And so I'm basically hiking from the base of Grindelwald up to the peaks, walking along underneath this incredible mountain range, and then back down into the second valley of Lauterbrunnen. All was taking no cable cars. All of these places that I've been to the last few days, all no cable cars. And today it has cost me £8 to do all of this, to see this. To like have these views, it's cost £8 compared to like whatever, like 60, 70 odd quid. So, yeah, bargain. So, you got Eiger there, and then you got a mountain called like Moench or Moench, I don't know, which is like 4,100 meters. So there it is, 99% sure that's Jungfrau over there. This one's the one at like 4,100. So there we go, the clouds cleared up over that summit, which is pretty cool. And then over here, this village on the other side, that's Murren, where I hiked up from Lauterbrunnen to get up there. And that's the place that I ran down from to catch the train. So, in fact, you can start to see where I hiked beyond Murren when I went up and it was like really cloudy. That crane where they're doing the work, I did see that. I basically walked, I think you can see like the saddle. I think I went like into that saddle and then back around again. So not quite up to that snowy peak, but around that peak and then down. But unfortunately that was the day where it was like really cloudy. So didn't get to see probably as much as I should have, but yeah, I can actually recognize the path that I took up from Murren. So there's Murren, and then just here you've got a path that comes up to this little let's focus. So we got this little saddle point, and then from there climbed up here and then walked along here and essentially went into this little dip here, and did like a circle at the base of this very snowy mountain here. Essentially did a circle around the top end of that and then down, trying to get this to focus a bit more, and then down this face here, from here, and then back along across and then into Murren. There we go, we've got Higer, we've got Earth 4001, and we've got Mountain over there. Now this is Lauterbrunnen, with some amazing views. This is like very Yosemite-esque. So that's kind of the end of that. That's the final hike I'll be doing in the Interlaken area. Today it's been about 5.5 hours, I think. I'll have to check, probably about between five and five and a half. Over 20 kilometers, so pushing towards again like 50 miles. It's been a really good day. Thankfully the clouds have cleared and stuff, so the views have been good. I'm really tired now, but there you go. Looking forward to what Lucerne brings.